This video will look at editing and annotating files. If I open an editable file, such as this interview here, and notice a mistake, here I can see it says environmental consultor instead of environmental consulting. If I try to edit, you can see the file's locked. This is really helpful because it can stop us accidentally affecting the underlying data as we're coding and reading our source material. This is really important for anyone working in a group project where you work independently and later merge your projects together. This does mean, however, that if you spot a mistake, you need to click on Edit at the top to unlock this file. As soon as it's unlocked, you'll notice you're then able to edit. Remember, once you've finished making any changes, you want to untick Edit to relock that file again and stop yourself from making any accidental mistakes. If you're working on a group project, you're best not to make any edits until your files are merged back together. If we look at Barbara's interview in a bit more detail, we can see further down there is an annotation. If you go to the annotation button at the top and click View Annotations, it will show all of these in the annotation pane at the bottom of the source. If you're not directly looking at a particular annotation, you can also click on the item number to scroll to that position in the document and see the annotation. Annotations are a great way for you to add more data to a document and record additional thoughts, feelings, or notes. For example, I want to make some notes about Beaufort Elementary, Middle and High School to say they're the only schools in the area. I've highlighted this particular reference. I can now right click and then choose New Annotation. The annotation pane at the bottom opens up with a new item number for me to type into, and I can add my note. This annotation will be a useful reminder for when I revisit this interview at a later date. These kind of annotations can be really helpful for group projects as well. You'll notice these exact same options also occur in memos. So if I open the memo we created in the last video, you'll notice I'll need to click here to edit. I also have the options to annotate this just like any other document. You can also see there's the ability to code and view coding stripes as well. So your memos can be a codable part of your data, just as with any other asset. This is really helpful for anyone who's co-researching, where your own thoughts and feelings are just as much as part of the project. Also, really helpful for autoethnography studies.